Hi guys, and welcome back to Happy Hour with Hope. You have not seen me in a few weeks because I have been in the middle of moving from Northern Virginia to Charleston, South Carolina. But I am back in Virginia this week for some work and some educational things. And so I am filming with my team for one more episode of Happy Hour with Hope while I'm here because I have something really exciting coming up that I wanted to tell you about. So if you're a senior photographer that tunes into my businesses or wants to learn more about my spokesmodel program and the senior side of my business, I am hosting a brand new 100% free mini course called the Spokesmodel Mini Course. And in my bio at the link, you can join us 100% for free. And every single day for 5 days, I'm giving you a mini, less than 10 minute lesson about my spokesmodel teams. And by the end of the mini course, you will have a full application, a full spokesmodel team structure, and a marketing plan to build a spokesmodel team to help grow the senior side of your business. I'm super excited about it. I have never offered a mini course like this. And again, it's 100% for free. And I would love to see you on the inside of that course. And today, to celebrate, I've decided to do a Q&A all about senior photography and spokesmodel teams to help give you guys a little bit of a peek of the content that we're going to be learning inside of that mini course. And because I got these questions from my followers, it's just a really fun way to give back to my audience and see what you guys want to learn. So my friend Erica is sitting over here to my right, and she's going to ask me the questions that you guys submitted, and I'm going to answer them off the cuff. So we'll see how this goes. Somebody asked, what's the best time of year to market to seniors on Instagram? I think that depends on where you live, but here the busiest times for photographing seniors are in the summer and in the fall. So in the seasons leading up to the summer, like the springtime, I'm posting really, really heavy senior content. Tons of behind the scenes looks, tons of pictures of me working with my girls, and then actual senior work too, because I'm priming my audience and preparing them to start booking during that busy season of summer and fall. So whatever the busy season is where you are, depending probably on the weather, you'll want to start marketing 2 to 3 months in advance before that busy booking season so your audience is ready to start booking those dates really quickly once it's time to get busy. Someone asked, how much work is it to have a spokesmodel program and is it worth it? The answer to the second question is yes, it is worth it if it's done correctly and strategically. I have lots of years of having a spokesmodel program where I didn't really plan strategically. It wasn't well thought out. There wasn't just a strategy at all, to be honest. And in those situations, it's not worth your time because it's not really something that's bringing you a return or bringing you bookings or bringing you success. But if you do it correctly and strategically and in a well-organized way, it is absolutely worth the time and it doesn't have to take up that much time. And we're gonna walk through all of that in the mini course below. So make sure you join us because I literally give you some step-by-step ways to set up your team in a way that's going to bring you success and not leave you feeling frustrated and resentful. Someone said they are struggling to reach their ideal senior clients on social media. Do I have any tips? Yes, I absolutely have tips because I'm a huge believer in personal marketing and incorporating who you are into your brand and into your business. I have an episode all about this, so go back and tune into that if you want to learn more about personal marketing. But I'm just a huge believer that incorporating who you are and your personality and the pieces of you that align with or relate to your ideal client is the best way to relate to them. So what I do is I make a list of features and personality traits of who my ideal client is, and then I make a list of my personality traits and I circle the ones that we have in common, and then I start incorporating those into the way that I market. Like, for example, I typically work from home in yoga pants and t-shirts, but I know that my senior clients dress really preppy and they care about cute outfits. So in the rare occasion that I do get dressed in a cute outfit, like for a filming day, I will take a picture and share that picture because I'm attracting that ideal senior audience to my business just by showing them that we care about the same things and dressing cute and stylizing our outfits. So find pieces of your personality and who you are that connect and relate to your ideal client and start incorporating them into the way that you share. Someone said, how do you fake it till you make it when you're in a small town? And I just moved from a small town in Virginia to Charleston, South Carolina. So girl, I hear you, I relate. For me, I don't think being in a small town necessarily affects whether you fake it till you make it or not, because there are still people that can model for you, still people that are your ideal clients likely in your area. And if they're not, for me, I lived in Fredericksburg, Virginia. So Washington, DC was about 60 miles from me. And Richmond, Virginia was about 60 miles from me. Those were the two biggest cities near me. And so I included 60 miles of travel in my packages and my pricing because I knew that my ideal clients who were willing to pay my prices or who maybe matched who my ideal client is in general were probably in those two cities. And so I included the mileage in my packages to let them know that I was willing to travel to them for no additional cost. And so that might be a really awesome strategy for you, is to market to people that maybe aren't in your immediate small town area, but in the closest biggest city to you. I hope that helps a little bit. Somebody asked if I gift my seniors anything, if I have anything for them as a surprise at their shoot, and if so, what? And the answer to that is yes, I do give my clients gifts, and I don't tell them that they're receiving it. It's a big surprise. And what I do is I have custom tumbler cups that have my logo on them and have a cute little straw with a bow. And I put it in a gift bag, and I have it waiting for them when they arrive to their shoot, because it's something really practical that they will likely use all the time, but can market for me in a really fun way. And it gives them a reason to post about me on social media. I have tons of girls that take like Snapchat videos and pictures with them and post them on their story. So they're cute and practical, but also really awesome marketing materials. And then the last question that I got a ton was, how do you price for your spokes model team and what do they receive? And the answer to that is that I price my spokes model team based on the cost of one individual senior session. So every one of my spokes models pays the cost of one senior session, but they get like 10 times more than what a normal senior client receives. They get to participate in events, they get tons of styled shoots and additional images throughout the year, they get to participate in a referral program. And again, I outline that way more in detail in the free mini course that I'm going to be hosting in a couple weeks. So make sure to join us at the link down below. And if you feel like you know anybody that might want to join or you want to share with your audience, share that link, because it'll provide accountability for you to make sure you actually show up each day of the mini course. And having someone complete the mini course alongside you is such a fun way to apply everything you've learned in a way that's going to help you see success in both of your businesses. And I appreciate you guys tuning in today so much. I hope that I see you inside that mini course, because we are going to have a blast, and I will see you in the next episode of Happy Hour with Hope. Bye.